can choose, and yeah, and you have to tell us something about the pictures.
Okay.
But
okay.
You can choose where you want to start. So,
all right.
Want to start?
I'll start with this one.
This one. Okay.
Okay. So,
who's that guy?
This is my friend George, which has a really bad shirt on that day.
Have you
seen it? You seen the shirt?
Yeah, but it's not good.
He hasn't got very good fashion sense, to be honest.
But you worked with him, right, at McLaren?
I joined there as a test driver when George was working for the catering company there.
And you met him at the catering?
Yeah, of course. that's where test drivers spend most of their time. It's in the kitchen.
So
we met at that time and became very, very good, very close friends. And now he's, he's a big car fan anyway, so he loves the racing, he loves that, and yeah, he comes along to a lot of the races and stuff, and yeah.
Yes. I think he's over there here
he's
right
over,
now.
He's over there, yeah, exactly. No, he's not, he's gone.
He's gone?
He's over there on the phone, so he's working.
Yeah. So he is here just to support you now?
Yep, just to support me. He's a good friend, and he comes from the same area as me in the UK. He works in London now, but he's born and family in the same area, so yeah, he comes up and we go out cycling and stuff like that. So.
Yeah, next picture.
That one. So this one.
Oh,
this is a good one. So this was when I was the first year I was test driver for McLaren in Formula One. I joined them at the end of 2005, and this was in 2006. This was the winter of 2005-06, basically.
Okay.
And the colour's great because it was between kind of different colour schemes, paint schemes for the car. So for the winter, they decided to paint it like the old McLarens, which were always this orange colour.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
So it was great. It was just really back to the old days. And the good thing is, also they had some, the branding sponsor was West at the time, which was obviously cigarette branding, so they couldn't run it. So whenever they took it off, they replaced the branding with your name. So if you see here, so it has, you can see it at the bottom, it has Gary on the car there.
Yeah.
So it's the only time I've had, and the whole side of the car just had Gary on the side of the car. So yeah, it was quite funny. But you know, this doesn't bring back kind of regrets or bad memories. Mm-hmm. It brings back good memories. I really enjoyed doing it, and really enjoyed being part of it. Mm-hmm. But I'm really proud and really happy where I've got to. So
is it hard, the switching between like DTM and Formula One?
It can be to start with. Yeah, you have to really get used to the different styles of the cars and the different demands. It's very easy to become quite good at both.
Okay.
You know,
yeah,
not really good at both. You have to really, to be able to adapt, to be really good at both things, because it's very, very easy to go in the middle and just become okay.
Okay.
So that's what you have to try and work on, is what each car needs to get the fastest thing out of it. So you can see I'm happy in there. I'm smiling in the car.
Yeah, of course, yeah. You see that? The smiling?
See, smiling eyes, yeah.
Yeah. A happy race driver. Okay, cool.
Right.
Next picture.
I'll go over here. This is a recent one. This is good. So
your boys.
Yeah, this is my three boys. So this was
in Zandvoort.
Yeah. This was Zandvoort this year, and this is my three boys. So Harvey, Freddie, and Alfie. Alfie has the hat on, the little one here, and he actually came on the podium with me, which was great. And
we in Germany say you look like the Orgelpfeifen. The Orgelpfeifen.
What's that?
You have to tell it. Orgelpfeifen? You have to.
Oh, the church.
Like this.
For me, this is what it's about. Is getting the family involved in what's going on. You know, I like my family to be involved. They don't come to as many races as I'd like. They have school. They have things they have to do. But when I got on the podium there, you know, I wanted to take them there, get them involved, get some great pictures, and just some great memories for me, but for them as well, you know.
It's great having a father who's a race driver, and then you are on the podium with the...
That's again just something, a very recent memory, I suppose,
Hopefully, we see you again on the podium with your guys.
Yes.
So,
right,
next picture.
One, this one here. This is older.
Yeah, it's older, but a really successful picture.
Yeah.
Like you.
Yeah. So this was at the DMSB awards dinner after 2005. After I won the DTM championship in 2005 with my good friend Matthias Ekström.
Yeah.
And I didn't remember Tom Kristensen actually finished third that year. I didn't remember that actually.
Yeah. You look younger.
Yeah.
Look at this. You were younger, but you really look younger. Perhaps you.
It was 11 years ago.
You should think about your beard.
Yeah, but it will make you really younger.
Yeah.
It was 11 years ago, so that's a long time. A lot's happened since then, but very good memories, obviously.
So, next picture.
Next one. Right in the middle here. Right, this one. The
middle picture.
Oh, look at this. Yeah, this is
you're like soccer.
Yeah. So there we go. This picture of I took at the Emirates Stadium, which I like football. I mean, you know, I'm a very sporty person. I like a lot of sports. I like playing things. But I'm very good at motorsport. I'm average at everything else, pretty much. But I like sports.
Yeah, but I heard you're not. You don't like only like the being. You don't only like the sport. You're like a really huge fan.
Yeah, I am. I mean, the funny thing is, I have no real links to Arsenal. I wasn't born near there, I think. But at a young age, I just liked the team, and I've supported them ever since. And my kids are supporters of them. And I get, Lisa would tell you, I get too excited watching TV with them playing. You know?
Yeah.
I mean, I sit in the lounge watching the
shouting.
TV. I go rah crazy, you know, and Lisa's just like, oh. She has to walk out the room because it's embarrassing, I think.
Yeah. Are you allowed to drink alcohol there? Like, if you really have some spare time?
Yeah,
like,
you do,
You have your normal, like a normal person, like with normal drinking beer, having hot dogs and everything?
Yeah, absolutely.
That sounds good.
Yeah. Good. Right, next, we'll go this one. Oh, this is an old one as well. So this is more recent. This is either, I don't know when, 2011 or 2012.
And I heard that's a really good friend.
And this is another very good friend of mine, yes. Yeah. This guy's name is Ty. And he's been a friend of mine since I was like 10 years old. So he used to work for the karting team that I used to race for. Mm-hmm. And so when I was 10 years old, he used to be there just helping out the team and stuff like that. And he's been a very good friend of mine since then. You know, he's followed me all through my career. You know, he up until recently he would come to like nearly every race, be there every weekend, and I mean everybody thought he was my manager because was there all the time.
But he was just a really good friend.
I mean, in the early days he used to give me some sponsorship from his company just to help me out and things like this. But generally, just a really good friend, really passionate about motorsport, and just really enjoys coming along.
What I see is like that it's for you really important that you have your friends with you, your family with you, like who supports you during the races.
Yeah, I just...
It gives you power?
Yeah. I mean, everybody enjoys coming, but I enjoy them being there. You know, it's, for me, when you're out of the car, to have people to chat to, just about normal stuff, you know, just to get away from, get your mind off the racing for a minute, just to chat about normal stuff is important. So, And the good thing is that all these people, you know, be it Lisa or Ty or George, the good thing is that they're really honest people with me. You know, I see a lot of people that have friends around them or managers around them that always tell them how great you are, and you're perfect, and you do this. These guys don't do this.
And perhaps sometimes you don't want to talk about races or something. You want to talk about something else.
These guys, like football. It's like, well, you did a pretty shit job there, didn't you? And it was like, Okay,
let's have a beer.
Yeah, exactly. So I think that's why I enjoy it. So,
yeah, I can imagine, yeah. So.
Good, we've got two left. I'm going to save this one. I'll go this one first over here. Wow, this is another old one. This is,
Before you tell me something about this picture, you have to tell me something about those pants.
They were in fashion at that point.
Yeah?
Yeah. No, they weren't.
Oh my God.
They're okay though.
They're okay.
It's just the combination.
They're not
with
okay.
The
they are like this, Steve Urkel, like Gary Paffett, Urkel.
My aim is to find a picture of Thor wearing something really bad.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm going to do. Yeah, it's going to be on my Twitter account as soon as I can possibly get it there.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
okay. Yeah. Is that right?
Good luck. But perhaps we can put a picture together, like Steve Urkel and Gary here, like this. No, but we won't talk about your pants. Right. We talk about this is the
father. This is Keke Rosberg.
Yeah, the father of Nico.
Yeah, the father of Nico. Yeah, this is Martin Hines, who was my manager at the time, who owned Zipcar, who supported me since I was 8 years old.
Yeah.
My engineer Erich Baumgartner, who is now Jamie Green's engineer in DTM.
Oh, really? Okay.
And this guy was crazy. Guy was called Malty Bongers or something. He was just a crazy guy, but he was a team manager at Team Rosberg Formula 3 team at the time.
Okay.
But yeah, this was in 2002. I hope I've saved a good one for last, because I've saved this one.
Yeah, yeah. And you did? Yeah, it's completely different. But
yeah, this is very different, this one, yeah. So, yeah.
So
this is a more personal picture.
This is from your farm, right?
We're a farm. I mean, I live right next to a farm. And I have a lot of animals, but I don't own a farm as such.
What kind of animals? You have like, you have dogs. Two dogs. Is it a cat or a dog?
I have five dogs.
Are you five dogs? Okay,
five dogs. My wife has five dogs.
Five dogs and three children.
Yes.
Lots of names to have in mind.
Yeah, but we also have three cats, and we have, at the moment, eight chickens. Yeah, so a little bit of a farm.
But the chickens don't have names. So
no. You can't give chickens names because they die too quickly.
Yeah. And they have even more names.
Yeah,
but exactly. It's sometimes that you call your children with the dogs' names.
No. But I genuinely have problem calling the kids their right names. Alfred, they're pretty hot. Whoever you over
kid
there.
One.
Yeah, exactly. One, two, and three is much easier. Yeah, but no, these are dogs in the garden, and again. Where I live at home, it's very different to the situation I have here. When you come here, it's all built up, it's all this. When I go home, it's out in the countryside.
Yeah.
You know, I just like when I go home to have some peace and quiet, you know, spend time with the family. I'm not a big city guy, you know. I don't like going to
London. Yeah, but you're always in big cities while you're during the races. So.
Yeah, exactly. So when I go home, I like the peace and quiet out in the countryside. So
yeah, cool.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, so that's it.
So great to see your photos, and hopefully we will see some more pictures of that.
Yes.
Here on the podium with your kids,
and maybe another one of them.
Yeah,
yeah,
but not one of these these panties.
No. There you go. Is this? Oh, that's a good picture.
Oh, look where it's going. Yeah, okay, but later. Who found it? Okay, now we.
That's a great picture.
Yeah,
but nice.
But I'm that. I'm not. I think
speechless.
Those pants are real. Here I'm just young. Here you are young and you have this pants on. So, okay, it's okay.
Thanks.
Yeah. All right. So, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you.
I'm gonna search for for pictures in the internet, and we will see what we will find.
Thanks.
Yeah.
All right.
Thanks.
Cheers. Mercedes-Benz, the best or nothing.